Hello everyone, Jagonkit here. It's been a while since the opening of the global server for the Lovebrush Chronicles. I've been intended to make yet another very very short rambling video, but then I couldn't manage to find a place and time where I can actually do the recording. So it's until now in November that I managed to record this. Yeah, so I'm not going to play the global server of the Lovebrush Chronicles. I will just stay on the Chinese server that I'm playing at the moment because I'm quite busy towards the end of year and I'm also quite lazy to start anew. Another things that I want to share, we have this very nice active Discord channel, so no matter you are in the China server or the global server, just join in, and it's a nice thing to have all these community discussions and people to scream at the characters or the new cards together. It's so nice. And then I personally not really into planning the resource, like how to spend my gems and everything like that, because well, gacha is literally just pure luck. Even with the PT system, I usually don't get what I want anyway. It's really luck based thing, then I just like whatever. Anyway, since this is an automate game, so that's one thing that you can totally prepare for it. And this is the only thing that I will prepare. I will actually save my stuff for these events. So remember these dates. Ta-da! These are the birthdays of the love interest. This is the most definite things in every automate game. So literally just remember those dates and plan the resources. As you can see, the first birthday will be Ayn's birthday. He is always the first in the round. So there's basically a so-called cycle of every characters. Yeah, so it will always start with Ayn's birthday in November and ends with Clarence's birthday in October. You would notice that the anniversary of the game itself actually is by the end of October. It's same for both the China server and the global server. Anyway, so Ayn's birthday is coming up next. And I think some nice person already put out what is going to happen, banners in the Facebook groups. So the character's birthday are always a definite and very confirmed date. So there's no need to think too much. Just remember to plan your resources. So if you want to draw the particular card for a particular character, then you know how to plan your resources. I think this is the main point of my video here. And these cute characters, the chibi icons, are from the Weibo emoticons that they released this year. It doesn't have any context, but their expressions are so cute and so adorable. So I'm looking forward to see people's writing feet on that. I personally, my headcanon is that I think there is something that we say complimenting them, saying they are very cute or something like that. I think that's why Ayn's have these very tsundere reactions, and then everyone just like a bit blushing, then smiling. And for Roshas or Lars, he just totally very proud of himself. Something like that, like, I think so. It's just my headcanon though, or just don't take it personally, okay? There's no official context for these emoticons, but they're just very cute and adorable. I will put them in the Tumblr. I don't know if the transparency is going to be stay there when I upload the pictures, but anyway, I will just put on my personal Tumblr there. So yeah, that's all for this rambling video. Everyone, enjoy the game, and if you have any questions, feedback, or you want to squeal over the characters, or you want to talk about the merch, just feel free to drop comments. And of course, because YouTube doesn't have a very good spoiler tag system, if you're talking something that's going to be spoiler and you don't mind spoiler, of course, then you just remember to have some spacing. Yeah, so we can talk about all those things without spoiling others.
That's all for this video. See you.